हेलो फ्रेंड्स,
दिस इज डॉक्टर वंदना वर्मा. वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू. एंड टुडेज लेक्चर इज ऑन द टॉपिक फिजियोलॉजी ऑफ स्वप्न, दैट इज ड्रीम. सो एज यू नो दैट इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द फिजियोलॉजी ऑफ स्लीप एंड इन कंटिन्यूएशन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द ड्रीम. सो a dream is a normal physiological phenomena which happens during the sleep, and the physiology of dream and the content and the purpose of dream, it is still not fully understood scientifically. But in Ayurveda, dreams has been described and its various implications has been described in relation to the psychosomatic constitution, in relation to the morbid condition of different disorders, so as well as its normal physiological process. It has been also described in terms of the dosh. So in the previous lecture, as we have discussed about the nidra, that is sleep, that yada tu manasi klante karmaatmana klamanvita vishyebhyo nivartante tada swapati mana, means when the man, that is mind, that gets fatigued, karmaatmana klamanvita, karmaatmana means the indriya, gyanendriya and the karmendriya, when they also get fatigued and disconnected with their respective stimulus or their respective vishay, in that condition there is generation of sleep. So basically the sleep is a state which arises when there is a physical and mental fatigue both simultaneously, and the dream, it is a state which occurs during the normal sleep. So how this dream arises during the normal sleep? Sleep is a normal physiological phenomena and which happens in all the individuals. So what is the physiology of dream? Acharya Vagbhat has given the verse, sarva indriya vyuparato mano apur anuparatam yada विषयेभ्यस्तदा स्वप्नम नाना रूपम प्रपश्यति, मीन्स सर्वेन्द्रिय व्योपरतो, ऑल द इंद्रिय, दैट इज सेंसरी ऑर्गन्स एंड द मोटर ऑर्गन्स, ज्ञानेन्द्रिय एंड कर्मेन्द्रिय, व्हेन दे गेट डिसकनेक्टेड विद देयर रिस्पेक्टिव फंक्शंस, बट मनो अनुपरतम, बट द माइंड डू नॉट गेट्स डिसकनेक्टेड विद द विषयेभ्य, mind do not get disconnected with its functions or its vishay, in that condition the person sees various kind of dreams. Swapnam means the dream, nana rupam means different varieties, prapashyati means seen. So the indriya, they get disconnected with their respective functions, but the mind, it do not get disconnected with its respective functions and its vision, means that the chintyam chayadhyam sankalpamevacha, all these are the vishaya. So when the mind do not gets disconnected with its functions, that is the imagination, ideation, thought process and analysis, so in that state during the sleep, dreams arises. So about this word, there is a commentary also that avishtayam cha nidrayam indriyeshu cha vishyebhyo nivritteshi mano yada swakarmano na nivrittaya. Here mano anuparatam means swakarmano na nivrittam. So but yada tu karanavashena mano api swakarmano nivrittam bhavati shasa sukta avastha. So when this mind, it also gets disconnected with its functions, so in that state person sleeps. तस्याम न किंचित पश्यति एंड ड्यूरिंग दैट स्टेट देर इज नो जनरेशन ऑफ ड्रीम. अबाउट दिस आचार्य सुश्रुत हैज ऑल्सो डिस्क्राइब्ड एंड दलित हैज गिवन दीज लाइन्स. निद्रा उपलब्धेन रजोयुक्तेन मनसा विषय ग्रहणम स्वप्ना. निद्रा उपलब्धेन मीन्स इन द स्टेट ऑफ स्लीप व्हेन. रजोयुक्तेन मनसा मनस माइंड मन गेट्स कनेक्टेड विद द रज विषय ग्रहणम. सो इन व्हेन द मन इज कनेक्टेड विद द रज इट इज कनेक्टेड विद इट्स सब्जेक्ट्स एंड ड्यूरिंग दैट स्टेट द there is generation of sleep. Swapna means dream. There is generation of dream during the sleep. So when during the sleep the manas is connected, gets connected with the rajagona, so in that condition it is not able to disconnect with its respective functions, and during that state, during the sleep, it is the cause for generation of sleep. Generation of dream. Now, how this modern science have described the dream? A dream is a succession of images, ideas, emotions, and sensations that usually occur involuntarily in the mind during the stages of sleep. So, and as we know that a normal adult person had 6 to 8 hours of sleep, duration of sleep, and the sleep has been divided into two stages on the basis of eye movement. So there are two stages, NREM sleep and REM sleep, that is non-rapid eye movement sleep and rapid eye movement sleep. Non-rapid eye movement sleep, it covers the maximum part of the dream, that is almost 70% of the sleep is of NREM type, whereas approximately 20 to 30% of the sleep duration is of REM type. And these every sleep cycle has these two stages, and in each cycle NREM is followed by REM. So during these these are the two stages of sleep, and in these two stages of the sleep the brain behaves differently. So as we know that during the sleep our cerebral cortex, especially the conscious part of the brain, all the neuronal activity is hugely depressed, and it is because of that the cortical neuronal activity is being regulated by the neurons which are present in reticular activation area. So but the reticular activation area neurons, they are during the sleep, even there are two theories of the dream, that they are when they get depressed, so there is a lesser discharge of reticular activator neuron to the cerebral cortex, that's why there is sleep. Another theory says that there is more activity of reticular activating neurons, that's why they secrete few active neurotransmitters, that is 5-HT and serotonin, and they inhibit the activity of cerebral cortex. So if we look the two parts of the brain, that is the conscious part of the brain and subconscious part of the brain, so during the sleep somehow the subconscious part of the brain, it is active, and the conscious part of the brain, it is in a state of rest. So the subconscious part of the brain, when it becomes more active during the sleep, it is somehow related with the dreams. So when the dreams they arise, so they are not uniform all over the sleep duration, rather they depend on the stage. So in the sleep, when they arise in NREM sleep, so there is again difference of opinion. Some scientists say that there is a dream may occur in the stage of NREM, some say there is no dream during the NREM stage of the sleep, but it may occur during this stage. Whereas REM sleep, definitely mainly the dreams they arise during this stage. And in the NREM sleep, if there is generation of dreams, so they are less vivid and memorable, whereas the dreams which occur during the state of REM sleep, they are related with the intense emotions. It may be related with the fear or rage or some excitement, and they are of vivid and memorable. NREM sleep dreams are usually not memorable during the awakened state. So it usually happens that we had dream in our during the sleep in night, but we are not able to recall that which kind of dream was that. But whereas sometimes it happens that we are able to recall the whole dream in a step manner even during the awakened state. So that dreams which we are able to recall, they generate during the REM sleep. That's why the dreams which occur during the REM sleep, they are called as memorable dreams. And the duration of dreams, usually it occurs from few seconds to the few minutes, up to the 15 to 20 minutes. So usually the dreams in REM sleep, they are of very shorter duration of few seconds or minutes. But in REM sleep, the dreams may be of longer duration, even of 15 to 20 minutes. And even they may be in fractions and in continuation during the whole period of sleep. Now, what is the mechanism of sleep? So, as I earlier told, that even the dream is a state which arises during the sleep. So, nowadays, there is no clear-cut neurobiology of even the sleep, or it has been not still identified that which part of brain which is specially related or which is responsible for generation of sleep. So it is still a matter of research nowadays. But the dream, since it is also a state which arises during the sleep, so its mechanism is not clear still. But on the basis of few researches, that is on the basis of few experimental researches, on the basis of clinical observations in some disorders, in case of medications, or in case of few injury of the brain, or in case or by the observations of the brain mapping, scientists have suggested the few parts of the brain which are related with the dream. So in this picture here, you can see that the part of the subconscious brain, that is the largest part of subconscious brain, is the limbic system and the brainstem. So it's a few parts are related with the dream and sleep. So the part of the limbic system, that is amygdala, hippocampus, parahippocampus, the cingulate gyrus, anterior group of thalamic nuclei, hypothalamus, all these are somehow related with the generation of dreams, which have been observed and suggested by the different researchers and scientists, especially the amygdala body, amygdaloid body, hippocampus, and the area of the reticular activating system of midbrain and pons. They are related with the generation of dream. And few areas of the occipital lobe and the prefrontal cortex, so the fibers association of the limbic system with the cerebral cortex, these pathways are maybe also related with the generation of dreams or different activities during the dreams. Like during the dream, sometimes there is awakening and there is a moment, some motor movements also. So all these motor movements which are regulated by the motor cortex, it is because of the feedback from the subconscious part of the brain. So in a study, it has been found that the emotional regulations during wakefulness and dreaming share a similar biological basis as amygdaloid, hippocampus, and medial prefrontal cortex in a sort of continuum between wakefulness and REM. And these structures may be responsible for the reprocessing and consolidation of emotional experiences during the REM sleep. Means these scientists, they have suggested that the the activity of the amygdala, hippocampus and the prefrontal cortex, medial prefrontal cortex. It was found same somehow during the REM sleep and the wakefulness state. Means this subconscious part of the brain, it is even active during the sleep also, and its activity is similar up to the wakeful state. So that's why they suggested that these parts, especially the hippocampus, it is related with the consolidation of the emotional experiences during the REM sleep, and this hippocampus, it is also related with the consolidation of different kind of memories and conversion of short-term memory into long-term memories. So these structures have been identified that they may be related with the generation of different kind of dreams. Similarly, in few scientists and researchers, they have also suggested that the higher activation of amygdaloid complex and hippocampal formation and anterior cingulate cortex in REM sleep than in wake, means they found that the activity of amygdaloid complex, hippocampal formation and anterior cingulate gyrus, it is more even during the wake time. Means the subconscious part of this part, these structures of the subconscious part of brain, they are more active even during the wakeful time. So these suggest that as in Ayurveda, it has been suggested that when the man gets connected with the Rajguna, then during the sleep there is generation of dreams. It means although the sleep is because of Tamguna and Kaphaguna, but when during the sleep it is associated with the Rajguna, so there is more activity of the manas, and that's why there is a dream. And this has been also observed by various researchers that during the REM sleep, when the most of the memorable dreams arise, during that higher activation of these parts have been found. Similarly, few brain mapping studies, they have also suggested regarding the brain activity of limbic system, paralimbic structure, pontine tegmentum and thalamus and basal forebrain during REM sleep as compared to the wakefulness and NREM sleep. Means these subconscious part of the subconscious part of the brain structures, that is limbic, paralimbic system structures and basal forebrain, all these have increased activity during the REM sleep. Now, as I earlier discussed, that there is no certain neurobiology of the sleep even today known. Few neurotransmitters have been suggested that the excess activity of the serotonin and 5-HT, that is serotonin and dopamine, it is related with the sleep. In the same manner, the scientist Solomons has given a mechanism related to the dream in year 2000, that he suggested a dopaminergic pathway is responsible for generation of sleep, and he said this is the areas, that is ventral tegmental area, this blue dot in the midbrain, this yellow area amygdala, and the prefrontal cortex A part, this prefrontal cortex part, they are there is the network of the dopaminergic pathway, and which is responsible for generation of dream during the sleep. And also suggested that the dream may be either related to the wish or some fulfillment, that is it may be either some goal directed behavior or it may be some desire related, or it may be related to the reward or punishment. So basically, it suggested that this dopamine and this dopaminergic pathway, which is related to the prefrontal cortex, it may be related to the generation of dreams. However, in few clinical observations also, it has been found that when a drug haloperidol, which is given as a medication to decrease the level of brain dopamine in certain conditions, So it has been observed that during the intake of haloperidol in the patients, decreased dreaming was found. So similarly, in another case, that is in case of Parkinson's disease, when L-DOPA is given to the patients to increase the level of brain dopamine, so in that case, excessive and vivid dreaming is found. So all these two observations also suggest that this dopamine is somehow related with the generation of dream during the sleep. Now, in Ayurveda, 7 kinds of dream has been described, and these dreams are based on the different kind of perceived experiences through the different sensory organs, or because of the thought of the mind, or it may be related with the some vitiated dose in the body. So the 7 dreams are drishtam, shrut anubhutam cha prarthitam kalpitam tatha bhavikam doshajam cheva swapnam sapta vidham vidu. Means the dreams cheva swapnam sapta vidham vidu means swapna jo hai wo cha, all the dreams are of 7 kinds. On the basis of these 7 categories, so first one is the drishtam. Drishtam means the dreams which are related with the some visual previous experiences. Shrut means the dreams which are related some auditory experiences, the things which have been already seen or things which have been already listened. So the dreams may be related to that. Anubhutam, anubhutam means here the experiences by other indriya, that is by the rasanendriya, this twakendriya, and other and the man also. So the other experiences related dreams may be also there. So this is the third category. Prarthitam means if someone has a strong desire for something, and so that may also come into the dream. Kalpitam, if there is imagination about something and there is a continuous thought for that, so that thing may come into the dream also. Bhavikam, the dream which is related to some future consequences. Or doshajam, a 7th kind is doshajam. Doshajam means when the dream is related to the some vitiated state of dosh, that is when there is a vitiation of vat, pitta and kapha. So as a clinical sign and symptom, in some disorders of vat, pitta, kapha, dreams has been also described. So when the manovai shrotas, they get occluded by the tridosh, so at that time also different kind of diseases arise, different kind of dreams may arise during the different kind of disorders. So among these drishta, shruta, anubhuta, prarthita, kalpita, all these are normal physiological dreams, but the bhavikam and doshajam, these two are not related with the normal physiological state. They are related somehow few disorders, like in case of vitiated vatpittika disorders. So these are the 7 kinds of dreams. Similarly, interpretation or the description has been given about the dreams in relation to the body constitution also. So Acharya Shushrut, Vagbhat, Charak, everyone has described about the Prakriti, and in Prakriti they have given about the dreams also. So as we know, the every person has dream during the normal sleep. But the kind of dream, it depends on the type of personality also. This is the concept which is given by given in Ayurveda in relation to the psychosomatic constitution, that a kind of dream may be a trait to determine a psychosomatic constitution of a person also. So as it is given that in a vat prakriti person, a person have the dominance of Vata dosha, and Vata dosha has dominance of Vayu Mahabhut. So a person sees the dreams like Vyati cha gachati sambhramena supta. Acharya Shushrut has given this, that a person during the sleep sees a moment in a space. Vyati means a space, akas, or sambhramena gachati, movement, or sambhramena flying or movement. So a person during the sleep sees movement into the sky. Similarly, Acharya Vagbhat has given shal drumaste gaganam chayanti, means the person says shal means the mountain and drum means the trees. So person sees climbing over the mountain or trees, or gaganam means the akash, or movement into the sky, or flying into the sky. Similarly, in case of pitta prakriti, since the pitta prakriti person has dominance of pitta dosh, and pitta dosha has dominance of Agni Mahabhut. So the person in dream, in normal physiological conditions, sees dreams which are symbolic of somehow Agni. So either there is a color similarity, or like in case of Kanak, Palash, Karnikaran, Shampashet, Cha, Hutash, Vidyut, Ulka. Means the person during the sleep sees the Kanak, means the gold, Palash, a plant which has red flowers, Karnika Karan, Shamprashyeta. So all these flowers can see, or all these kind of colors can see a person in dream. Or Hutash means Agni, fire, Vidyut, electricity, or you can say Ulka means some meteorites. So the person sees in dreams of the fire, or the golden color or red color objects into the dreams. Similarly, the Kaf Prakriti person has the dominance of Kaf Dosh in constitutionally, and has Kaf Dosh has dominance of Jal Mahabhut. So person always sees in the dreams regarding the Jalashay, means the water body. So Supta San Sa Kamal Hansa Chakra Vakana Shampashet Apicha Jalashayana Manogyana. So a person during the sleep sees Jalashay, water bodies, Kamal, Hans, and Chakra, a kind of birds, into the dreams. So in Ayurveda, it is conceptualized that each and every person has a specific kind of dreams as per his or her psychosomatic constitution, and they may be considered as a trait in determining the assessment in determination or in assessment of prakriti also. Dreams as predictor of morbidity. Manovahanam purdatvat dosha अति बलय स्त्रिभि श्रोतसाम दारुणान स्वप्नान काले पश्यति दारुणे न अति प्रसुप्तः पुरुषः साफलान अफलाश तथा इंद्रियेशेन मनसा स्वप्नान पश्येत अनेकथा. Here in this verse, Acharya Charak has described dreams, and the dreams related to the present, past, or future events, and their relation to the morbid conditions of various disorders. So in the Indriya Sthan, Acharya Charak has described that a person can see a various kind of dreams in the terminal stage of diseases, and that dreams may be a definitive sign towards the death. So the interpretation of dreams during the normal physiological state has been given, as in case of psychosomatic constitution, as well as in a pathological condition also a detailed description has been given. And Acharya Charak has given dreams related to all the Gyanendriya, means related to all the Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa, Gandha, related to all the stimulus. He has given a detailed description in different disorders, that during the terminal stage of disease, if a person sees such kind of dreams, so there may be sure death. So regarding its pathophysiology, he has given this verse manovahanam purnatvat. When the manovah shrotas, purnatvat means completely, doshaye ati balay stribhi. The tridosh, tribhi means the three, balay means in excess, doshe vatpitta kaph. So when the vatpitta kaph gets excessively vitiated and they occlude or obstruct the manovah shrotas, darunan shapnan kale pashyati darunai. So the person sees different kind of dreams during the morbid conditions of the disorders. Na atiprasupta. And the person sees such kind of dreams when it is person is not in a deep sleep. Purusha means the person, and that dreams may be related to safalash, means that dreams may be related to some certain conditions, or they may be predictor of some certain conditions like sure death, or they may not be related to some certain interpretations or certain manifestations. So when the indriya shena manasa, when the mind is the regulator of indriya, so when this manas sees the different kind of dreams during the sleep, or when the person is not in a deep sleep, in a state of obstruction of manovahshrotas by the tridosh, and during the different disorders, so all those dreams may be related to the terminal stage of disease, and may be the sure symptoms or sign of death. So this is all about the dream. What is the physiology of dream? What are its type? What are its interpretations? So this is the unique contribution of Ayurveda regarding the dreams, that its association with the personality types and its association with the certain morbid condition of the disorder, that when the person is in its terminal stage of disease, person has certain kind of dreams, and which are sure sign of death. Although the till date the dream interpretation has not been very scientifically proved or understood, and all these things need to be understood on the scientific parameters. Another state related to the dream is tandra. So we have discussed the sleep dream, and this is the tandra is the state which is just prior to the sleep, or we can say it is a strong urge for the sleep. So it is a state of strong urge for the sleep. Regarding the tandra, so what is the reason of this tandra? Acharya Shishrut has given this verse: Murcha pitta tamas praya raja pitta anilat brahma tamo vat kafas tandra nidra shleshma tamo bhava. Means murcha is a state of syncope. When there is a pit and tam is in excess in manovashrotas, so that state arises murcha. When there is a pit and vata dosh associated with the dominance of raj, that leads to the stage of brahm vertigo. Tamo vata kafas tandra. When there is vat and kaf dosh are associated with the tam, then that is condition gives the state of tandra. Nidra shleshma tamo bhava. And sleep is because of kaf and tam dosh. So as we know, the normal sleep is because of the tam guna of the man, and among the tridosh, it is the kaf which is responsible for normal generation of sleep during the night time. But tandra is the state just before the sleep. So when kaf and tam is associated with the, kaf and tam is responsible for sleep, and just before the sleep there is dominance of vata dosha. So the kaf and tam is associated with the vata, so that state gives a state of tandra. So when there is a there is excess of vata dosh, so that may be the cause for improper sleep, and that may gives the state of sleepiness or drowsiness only. So the proper, for the proper sleep only, there should be a dominance of tam and shlesham. It should not be associated with the vata. So tandra is basically, there are certain subjective perceptions also, like during the tandra there is a feeling of tiredness and there is a wanting of sleep. Thank you. This is all about the dream. We will continue with some new topic in the next lecture. So thank you all.